code, and girls, you should do it.
So Girls Who Code was created by the original founder to help solve the problem right now in the software engineer field of the lack of women in field. In fact, out of only 3 out of 25 women in the field are software engineers, and statistically, only 36 out of the 300 people here today would be women. So I'll give it to Grace to show why this is shocking now.
So I feel like most of us would agree that since the 1980s, society has become more friendly towards women. However, the statistics in computer science do not agree with that. And as you can see, in 1984, 37% of computer science graduates were women, and now that's down to 18%. This is a problem that all of us have experienced in computer science classes at school, where most of us are just one or two girls in a room full of boys. This also creates a problem in the workforce, because many studies have shown that the more diverse a group is, the more creative and innovative their ideas are.
$1.4 million. That's the amount of computer science jobs we'll have in the next 5 years. And only 29% of the jobs that will be filled will be from people who graduated the colleges in the US. And only 3% of those will be women.
So where does the drop-off occur? Young girls love computers, well as high school. Kind of awful time of life. girls are told they have to be perfect, and computer science is not a perfect field. You fail a lot, and it doesn't really mesh with the high expectations that the world has for girls. So the girls just kind of leave the field. And Girls Who Code is working to rectify that problem by re-interesting girls in coding and software engineering and just tech in general.
So, the mission.
The Girls Who Code mission is to close the gender gap in technology. It is our mission to inspire, educate, and equip girls with the computing skills to pursue 21st century opportunities in tech.
So what does a club look like? A club mostly looks like a group of girls with computers and internet access and an instructor. As long as you have that dedicated space and that opportunity, you can create your own Girls Who Code club, and you totally should. It's 40 hours per session. Typically that 40 hours is split over a school year, but it depends on the club. It's typically about 2 hours per session, depending on the club. And it's a self-paced, three-level curriculum. 20 of those 40 hours is spent on that self-paced learning, and then the other 20 hours are the project. This is what the curriculum looks like over the various levels. I would say for the most part, Girls Who Code is pretty agnostic when it comes to languages, but basically the first level is about core principles of code, variables, loops, conditionals. The second level is honing in on those core concepts and then teaching a little bit of web, a little bit of graphics, a tiny bit of SQL. The third level is APIs, mobile, responsive web design, 3D graphics, video games. But what's really cool about Girls Who Code, and what I think is the best part of this, is that the project is such a big part of the club. It's fully half of the committed hours. And I don't know about you, but I don't tend to learn things and retain them unless I actually apply it to something I love. So I think that's one thing that Girls Who Code gets right. It's also about teamwork. I put that as kind of a catch-all term, but really these girls were asked to be the product owners, the project managers, and the developers on this. And I don't know about you, but that's hard enough in a business, let alone for high school girls who just met and are just learning code. They did a really wonderful job working together. They also practiced project management techniques and agile development. We had two sprints. We had stand-up every day. We also had a Kanban board, and we practiced breaking stuff down into user stories. And then, no pressure, but the project is supposed to better their community. I think I was probably more worried about this piece than they do, than they were, but they came up with something that I think is really awesome. And that is another core principle of Girls Who Code, is that you're supposed to do good. It's also fun. So, what did our club look like? This was the Abrahams Branch Club. We were the first club in Omaha. This was in partnership with the Omaha Public Library. This was on our project demo slash presentation day, and we were pretty giddy to be done with everything after a long haul of 20 weeks. We had 6 high school graduates and 10 middle school graduates, and we had a ton of volunteers. There is no money that comes from the national organization. This was all donated with generous sponsors and a core group of volunteers, including Sandy Barr, who is the organizers today, Shauna Dorsey, Head of Interface, Marvel Mary, a partner in partnership with Omaha Public Library. Naomi C. was our awesome organizer, and she kept us all in line. Eris Colazar was the instructor for the middle school girls, and Lani Yeager started out as the high school instructor until I took over based on her member commitments, but she is a teacher itself. And now I want to show you the cool thing we built, that they built, I should say. So I'm going to let them take it away.
So, 10 weeks before graduation, we sat down to a 2-hour brainstorming session. And I don't know if any of you have ever worked with high school girls, but it was not the easiest thing to get us to agree on stuff. But by the end of that, we came up with Tech Around O, which is a resource for local young people in Omaha to connect with tech opportunities so that they can follow their passion and get inspired like Girls Who Code allowed us to. I'll let Sarah show you around the site.
So we're starting off on our homepage. Our crowning jewel of this page is our carousel. While we were making it, if it could break, it did. We had at one point, you couldn't click anything. We had another where it wouldn't link to anything. And at one point, you just couldn't read it at all. Below our carousel is a short description of what Tech Around O is. It gives our like mission statement and what you can find on our website. Our footer includes our company name, who made it, and then an email where people can send us questions, compliments, and hopefully not any complaints. This is our nav bar that gives that shows all of our pages. Our first page is our people page that has profiles of various people in the tech scene around Omaha. We sent out interviews early on in the process, and they responded. And this is a short description, and then if you click on their names, you get a longer interview of things that they've sent out, questions that we think that youth would enjoy hearing about. Our next page is our opportunities page, which has short descriptions of various clubs, groups, camps, meetups in the Omaha metro area that would be designed for youth. So each of these is a link for the website that is there so they can see more information and get signed up. And I will give it over to Tara and Julie so they can talk about our game.
And as you can see on this page, we have our own card on the nav bar, which is kind of nice. We made 2 games. One for JavaScript and one for Visual Basic. We just chose it based off of what we kind of already have some experience with. And I did a lot of the front end work. I'm just going to do a quick demo. This is the JavaScript part. I wrote most of the questions and answers for JavaScript. And an interesting point is I made the scores board, which took a long time. I was not fun trying to figure out what kept going wrong. I even had to look at other code areas that did this. But the basic concept is I can scroll correctly, that would be wonderful. We made a scoreboard, and we, right here, had a fun for a second. We wrote we basically defined points as a variable and made it equal to zero at the beginning. And then we just basically decided, okay, we're going to call this part point board, and it displays through codesters. I'm not sure if it does this on other parts of Python, but this is what we used. And as you can see here, for each variable that we used, we had to define it as a global variable. And right about here, we had it add points if we got the questions correct, or just kind of not add points if we got it incorrect. And since we are on the code, I will hand this over to Tara.
So I did a lot of the back-end stuff, though Julie helped a lot, which, for the record, I've never been very good at. Debugging is not the funnest thing to do, if you agree with me. So what we started off with, our first problem out of many problems that occurred, was how are we going to input the answer for the quiz. So we decided just to have them input it from their keyboard, A through D, and so once they input their answer, we have an array of the correct answers up there, as you can see, and then, like, once we get the correct answer and we match it up with the answer that the user outputted, we either output the correct sign and move on, or we output the incorrect sign. So a lot of problems that kind of came up with this was kind of trying to like find out how we could stop like the arrays and what we could do to kind of make it continue. And I would really like to thank Wendy for helping us on this a lot, because we really learned the most when we were actually creating the code. So that's kind of this is right here that you're seeing is almost all of the work. And you'd think something that took 20 hours would not be like 20 lines of code, but anyway.
So most of us had never had any experience with code before creating this, and we learned a lot. We started out in CodePen, where our website was just a whole bunch of pictures of Taylor Swift for a while. my decision. Then we went to GitHub, where we host the site now, and then we had to learn Bootstrap. We added a favicon, which I didn't even know what that was. So it was just a really great experience, and like Tara said, making an actual project is a lot different than the lessons we learned in school, and I feel like we can never be where we were if we hadn't had this experience, so I'll give it to Sarah for the last page of the website.
Like I said, this is our last page, so we are almost done. This page is about us. And no, we're not bragging about ourselves. We made this page so you can see that we did it. And they can do it too. I didn't know anything about coding until I started in March, and I helped make this website, so they can do it too. Like a short description of who we are, what we like outside of coding, and it tells us what we did on the project. So I worked on content in HTML, and I'm Sarah, by the way.
I'm Grace. I did a lot of the web development, and I also was in charge of design and layout at the site.
I'm Julie, and I did a lot of the front-end work for the game. I made all the images for the winning and correct and incorrect screens.
I'm Tara, and I worked a lot on the back end of the game project, where we wrote it in Python. I also created the Visual Basic questions.
And two people who weren't able to be here are Ruby and Ramya, and they also worked on HTML, content, design, really just about everything. So Grace has some closing remarks, and then Wendy's going to talk just a little more.
So we said at the beginning that Girls Who Code's mission was to educate and inspire girls, And I think that we are a very good example of that. None of us knew each other before we came in. We definitely did not know how to make a website, but we all came together and were able to work together with like strong mentors like Wendy, and we got it done. So
they did an amazing job. I think they deserve a round of applause. Basically, encourage other girls to do this too. This is an awesome program. This was one session. Most of these girls had no code experience. They can do it too, to grades 6th to 12th grade. This is a completely volunteer effort, and we could not do it without sponsors. There's no money that comes into this. We relied on sponsors for space and computers and time and money, and also, as the girls will tell you, food was super helpful because they're very hungry. we need volunteers. This is all run off of volunteers. There's four different roles we've identified, which are from being instructors. If you want to be an instructor, you can actually start your own club. Teaching assistants, we needed plenty of those. If you've ever had 10 girls ask you these questions at once, you know how important it is to have more than one person in the room who knows how to answer that question. We also have organizers. That's a very key role. And I'm blanking on the last role. Somebody help me.
Speakers,
thank you so much. We had four speakers come in to talk to the girls about what the community was like. And I think that was so helpful because it gave them a feeling of what this community is about. We've got an awesome alma mater community. Also, since we're talking in this room and all of you are software engineers, if only three women, in a room of 25 engineers, only three are women, we don't have enough female mentors to go around, and we don't have enough of them to make an impact. So if you, I'm reaching out to the men in the audience now. If you support this mission, please consider mentoring a young woman or a young girl in tech. It's so important to get that in there. And we're not going to get to gender parity unless the men in this audience help us. So. But I want to say, especially if you know a girl, we are actually accepting applications. It is so cool that we went from one club 6 months ago to three clubs in Omaha today. We have two of the two clubs actually accepting applications today. The Omaha Public Library's next session starts. It'll start September 17th. Applications close tomorrow, and we're the only high school club in town. So if you have any girl who is interested, she should totally apply. AIM Brain Exchange is offering a club. They're not accepting applications, but it's awesome that they're starting this too. And Do Space is also starting a club for middle school girls, and their application closes next week. You can find more information on the Omaha Girls Who Code site under clubs. So if you go to the clubs page, you can apply, you can find out more information about how to sponsor or be a volunteer. Or you can also contact any of us. We'd love that. Any last remarks, girls? Great.
Now we're going to take a selfie.
We'll give you 2 months.